A very good morning and Jai Hind, children. Children, I hope you all are preparing for your test. Children, in the chapter Light, Shadows and Reflection, we have done almost the book part of the activity. Book activity we have completed. We have done the exercises also. So children, today we'll do the short answer questions and long answer question and halts. Okay, so and also we'll do, I have already told you about the activity that light travels in a straight line, but I have not demonstrated it to you. So today I'll send you the link. You can easily see the activity, that is how light travels in a straight line. So today we will do short answer questions, long answer question and halts along with the activity. Children, there are many diagrams that you have to draw in your physics notebook. So all the diagrams that you are going to draw, you will draw it on the plain side of the paper in front of the respective questions. Okay, so you can draw a colorful diagram, or you can just draw it like that. And children, please do mention the figure name which is written below. Okay, so let's quickly start with the chapter. So today we'll do first the short answer question, then long answer question, then halts. So I'm now going to share the screen. Okay, chapter 12, Light, Shadows and Reflection. We have done oral question 1. We have done oral question 2. We have done this choose the most appropriate answer. We have done very short answer questions also. Okay. So let's quickly start with short answer questions. Okay, so for short answer question, children, this you will write in fair notebook. Question you will write with black pen, and answers you will write with blue pen. Okay. And please write it very neatly. So let's start. Question 1. We see the sun rising 1/4 minutes after it has actually risen. Why? So the question says, we see the sun that we see it after 1/4 minutes that it has already risen. Okay, why? What is the reason? So the reason is, light travels from the sun to the earth in 1/4 minutes. So we see the sun rising 1/4 minutes after it has actually risen. Now children, we are able to see anything only when the light that is reflected from the object comes to our eyes, isn't it? Jab wo light hamari eyes pe reflect karti hai, tabhi hum kisi object ko dekh pate hai. So here, the light of sun takes 1/4 minutes to reach the earth. And reaching the earth means reaching our eyes. So it takes 1/4 minutes, that is why we see the sun after 1/4 minutes, that like after it has actually risen. Okay, so I hope it is clear. Question 2. Name 2 natural sources of light and 2 human made sources of light. So I think this is very clear to you. What are natural sources of light? The objects that emit light naturally are called natural sources of light. Human-made sources of light, the object or the things that human have made are called human-made sources of light. So, sun and fireflies is Jugnu. I hope you must have seen Jugnu. So, sun and firefly are natural sources of light, whereas candle, electric bulb are artificial sources of light. So this candle and electric bulb are artificial sources of light, whereas sun and fireflies are natural source of light. Okay. Now question 3. How do we see non-luminous object? Children, non-luminous objects are those objects that does not emit light. So if the object is not emitting light, how we are able to see them? So you know the answer. What is the answer? Because the light gets reflected from it. So let's see what is written. When light falls on non-luminous object, it gets reflected in different directions. When these light, reflected light, reaches our eyes, we can see the object. Okay? So if there is one non-luminous object, how we can see them? When the light falls on that object and it reflects back to our eyes, then we are able to see the non-luminous object. And luminous object we can easily see, isn't it? So let's go to next. We have question 4. What is meant by rectilinear propagation of light? What is rectilinear propagation of light, children? The property of light traveling in a straight line is called rectilinear propagation of light. So we know that light always travels in a straight line. Okay, this activity only today I'll demonstrate, and I will send the link and you can see in the group. So we know that light travels in a straight line, and this property of light traveling in a straight line is called rectilinear propagation of light. What it is called? Rectilinear propagation of light. Children, in front of this answer, on the plane side, you will draw this diagram. Here we have rays, beams and the divergent beam. So this you will draw in front of this answer. Okay, and children, you will write this also. A ray of beam, B, a beam of parallel rays of light, C, a beam of light from a small source of light. So this you will draw in front of this answer. Okay, question 5. What are translucent objects? So what are translucent objects? The objects through which we can not see clearly, though we can see but we cannot see clearly, is called translucent object. So let's see what is written. And through it light partially passes. Okay, so translucent objects are those objects that allows some light to pass through but not enough to enable us to see clearly through it. Translucent object kya hota hai? Ki jab hum usse clearly nahi dekh pate. Hum light to dekh lenge par hum usko clearly nahi dekh payenge. So this is translucent object, and light also passes partially. So example is butter paper and ground glass. So what is the example? Butter paper and ground glass are the example of translucent objects. Okay. Now coming to question 6. When is a shadow formed? So a shadow is formed when light from a source is obstructed by an opaque object. So we know how shadow is formed. So for shadow to be formed, we require opaque object, we require a source of light. So when a light is passing through a opaque object, then shadow is formed. So what is opaque object? The object through which light cannot pass is opaque object. Okay, question number 7. Why does a solar eclipse always occur on a new moon day? So what is new moon day? In which the sun is moon is completely visible. So let's see. During solar eclipse, the dark side of moon faces the earth. Therefore, a solar eclipse always occurs on a new moon day. Okay? So why solar eclipse occur on new moon day? Because the dark side of moon faces the earth that time. That is why we are not able to see the moon on new moon day. Okay? So clear, children? This is answer number 7. During a solar eclipse, the dark side of moon faces the earth. Therefore, a solar eclipse always occurs on a new moon day. Question number 8. When can you see an image of an object in a plane mirror? Plane mirror mein aap kab image dekh sakte hain? So let's see. We can see an image of an object in a plane mirror when light from the object reaches our eyes after reflection from the plane mirror. So we have a plane mirror. ठीक है? अगर हमको उसमें अपनी इमेज देखनी है तो हम कैसे देखेंगे? जब सोर्स ऑफ लाइट आएगा और वो उस पे रिफ्लेक्ट करके हमारी आईज पे जाएंगे तब हम इमेज को देख सकते हैं. So when light from the object reaches our eyes after reflection from the plane mirror, then only we can see the image of an object. So that was about short answer question. So there were 8 short answer questions. Children, you can write it down. I'll send this PDF to you. So you can write it from here. Okay, now long answer questions. So we depend on light energy for food and fuel. Explain. Question number 1 is, we depend on light energy for food and fuel. Light energy means the energy of sun is a light energy. So we depend on light energy for food and fuel. So for our body, children, what acts as a fuel? हमारी बॉडी के लिए फ्यूल की तरह कौन एक्ट करता है? एंड व्हाट इज फ्यूल? फ्यूल इज एन एनर्जी दैट अनेबल्स अस टू डू समथिंग. तो ऐसी कौन सी चीज है जो हमारी बॉडी में फ्यूल की तरह एक्ट करती है? दैट इज ऑक्सीजन. ओके, व्हेन वी आर इनहेलिंग ऑक्सीजन देन ओनली वी कैन प्रोड्यूस एनर्जी एंड देन ओनली वी कैन walk, we can talk, we can perform daily activities. Okay, so we depend on light energy for food and fuel. Explain. Let's see what is written. We depend on light energy for food, oxygen and fuel because green plants prepare food using energy of light. Similarly, the energy of all fossil fuels such as petroleum, coal and natural gas has also been derived from light energy of the sun. So now the question, what the answer is saying that for we, like a human, to survive we require oxygen. Okay, we require oxygen to inhale and then only we can survive. So oxygen we are getting it from plants. And how plants are preparing oxygen? By the process of photosynthesis. Or photosynthesis ki process kaise ho rahi hai? Sunlight ki presence mein. Okay? So ultimately the oxygen that we are getting we are getting from plants, and plant is preparing that oxygen from sunlight. So to gain the fuel, we require sunlight or any light energy. Okay, and also there are certain fossil fuels like coal, petroleum, natural gases. For them also sunlight acts as a source of energy. So for everything that we are doing, for like we are surviving or we are doing anything, we require a light energy. Okay, now question number 2 here. In this question we have to show experimentally that light travels in a straight line. Okay, so we have done this activity. So we will do here this cardboard activity. So what we have done, we have taken 3 rectangular cardboards and we have just made a hole in a straight line. Okay, then we have put the candle in front of it and we try to see it from the hole. So we can easily see the flame of candle. But if we remove one cardboard and we shift one cardboard from the middle and then we try to see it, we will not be able to see. Okay, which proves that light travels in a straight line. So let's see what is written. Take 3 rectangular pieces of cardboard. You can see here there are 3 rectangular pieces of cardboard. Make a hole in them at exactly same level. So you can see the holes here in exactly the same level. Keep a burning candle on the table with its flame at the level of the hole. So we have kept the burning candle and the flame should be in the level of the hole. Okay, now adjust. So if we see it from here, we can easily see the flame of the candle. But now if we adjust the cardboard so that we can see the candle flame through the holes, we will find that flame can only be seen when holes are exactly in a straight line. Children, if we remove or we shift this central cardboard a bit, so that light will be blocked. Okay, and we will not be able to see the flame of candle clearly. So this experiment proves that light travels in a straight line. It cannot follow any zigzag pattern. Okay, so this was question number 2. Children, you will draw this diagram in front of this question and you will write here also figure to show light travels in a straight line. This also you will write below the figure, and figure you will draw in plain side of the paper. Okay, now question number 3. Children, all these diagrams are already there in your book, so you can see it from there if it is not clear. Question number 3. List 3 properties of shadow. So what are the 3 properties of shadow? We know that shadows is always black in color. We know that it is similar in shape of the object and it does not show any details of the object. So the 3 properties of shadows are: shadows is black in color, it is similar to the shape of object, and it does not show any details of the object. So these are the 3 properties of shadow. Okay, there are more properties, like we can adjust the shape of shadow, we can increase and decrease the shape and size of the shadow. So these are the properties of shadows. Children, you will draw this diagram is there in your book. You will draw this diagram in front of this answer number 3. Children, I want all the diagrams in your notebook. Okay, now question number 4. Draw a diagram to show the eclipse of the sun. Mark the areas where you can see total solar eclipse and partial solar eclipse. So children, you will draw this diagram to show the solar eclipse. So we know in solar eclipse what happens, moon is in between sun and earth. Moon is in between sun and earth. And there are total solar eclipse formed and a partial solar eclipse formed. So in region C, you can see here region C, the sun will be blocked totally. So these places total solar eclipse can be seen. Aur yahan pe kya ho raha hai between A and B? Aadha visible hai, aadha visible nahi hai. So it is partial solar eclipse. So you will write this and you will draw this diagram. Now coming to question number 5. In what ways is an image different from shadow? Image or shadows kaise ek dusre se different hai? So we know that image is of same color, but shadows are of black color. Shadows are similar in shape of the object but shows no detail, whereas image is not only the same shape as the object but has all the details that object has. तो इमेज में हमें सारी डिटेल्स दिखती हैं पर शेडो में हमें डिटेल्स नहीं दिखती हैं. शेडो हमेशा ब्लैक कलर का होता है बट इमेज सेम कलर का होता है एज ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट. सो दीज वर द डिफरेंस बिटवीन इमेज एंड शेडोज. ओके नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 6. For question number 6, you have to draw this pinhole camera. So this is pinhole camera. I hope you are very much clear about this. So what is this? It does not form any erect image. The image is always inverted. No glass screen is seen. Okay. And we can change the shape of this image depending on the source of light. So this is pinhole camera. You will draw this diagram. So you will only write the question and in front of that you will draw the diagram. Okay. Then we have next, in this also you have to draw this diagram. You will draw this diagram to show reflection of ray of light by a plane mirror. So here what we have done, we have taken a box. We have put a comb here and we are passing our source of light with the help of torch. Again we have a plane mirror here, so when we'll pass the light we can easily see the reflected light. So you will draw this diagram and you will write below it reflection of light rays by a plane mirror. So these diagrams and these answers you will write in fair notebook. I hope it is clear. So this was about long answer question and short answer questions. Now coming on to Hort's question. Okay, so these are very interesting types of questions, children. Let's quickly see. Which of these, a completely transparent object or a translucent object, will form a shadow? Will the shadow formed by an opaque object be darker or lighter than this shadow? Children, we know that for a shadow shoot to be formed, there has to be certain obstruction. कोई चीज obstruct करनी चाहिए तभी shadow form होगा. So we have three types of object: transparent, translucent, and opaque. So we are pretty much sure that opaque object will form a shadow. But what about transparent and translucent object? So see, in a transparent object, we have nothing to obstruct. So transparent object will not form any shadow. But translucent object? Translucent object can form shadow because light is passed partially through it. So it can form shadow, but the shadow will not be very dark. It will be a lighter shadow. So let's see what is written. A translucent object will form a shadow. darker, the question says, will the shadow formed by opaque object be darker? So yes, it will be darker because no light can pass through an opaque object. तो जब opaque object से कोई shadow बनती है तो वो dark होती है, translucent object से बनेगी तो वो light होगी. Okay, but transparent object cannot form shadow. Now coming to next, can an object form two or more shadows at same time? How can an object form two or more shadows at the same time? क्या एक टाइम में दो या दो से ज्यादा shadows form हो सकती है? Definitely yes. अगर different sources of light है तो let's see. Yes, when there are more than one sources of light, अगर एक से ज्यादा source of light है, then more than one or more than two image shadows can be formed. So a shadow is formed from each light source present in a scene. Therefore, two or more shadows can be formed at the same time by the object. Okay? So if there are more than one sources of light, we can easily see the two or more shadows. Next we have, what will be the color of shadow formed in red light? It will be black. Shadows are always black in color. So it will be black. Question 4. Does a pinhole camera form an image or a shadow of an object? Justify. So we know it forms an image, it does not form shadow. Can a pinhole camera form an image which is bigger than the object? Yes, I have told you, depending on the source of light, it can increase or decrease the size of the object. Okay, so this was about the long answer question, short question and long answer questions, short answer questions. So we have done all the exercise. So we have done all the exercise of this chapter. Children, please complete your work, short answer, long answer and hot's question. And now I am going to send a link, a video to show the activity that light travels in a straight line. So please have a look at it. Please complete your work and do prepare for your test. Okay. So that's all for today's class. Have a great day, have a very nice day, and children, start studying, be safe at your home. Okay, thank you and Jai Hind.